Okay, you ready? Boy, we miss Claude, but you know, he has left such an incredible legacy, you know, and I got to know him so well in the 70s, you know, and when the clubs started and when the festival started, and I wasn't there in the very beginning, but I think the first time was maybe 77, and I was quite young then, and it was the old casino, and it was just a great room. Everybody either stood up or sat on the carpet, sat on the floor. There were no chairs, and everyone was very squished together and close, and it was just a great feeling. And there was only that one room. There might have been one little tiny other jazz room, but that was the main room. That's where everybody played, whether you were the rock group or the jazz group or whoever. I think for me, one of the most fun things, and it happened a few times where B.B. King would play here, and B.B. would always go on last, where at Stravinsky Hall or wherever he was playing, and it would be, you know, 2 or 3 in the morning by the time he was finished, and then he'd want to have his jam session, and he always invited me for the jam session, and then Claude would come out and play harmonica, and Claude only had, I think it was just the C harmonica, so we always had to play the blues in C, so we always laughed because we knew it was always going to be blues in C with Claude. Claude, you know, wherever you are, up in heaven and with all the jazz greats, I know you're enjoying your life up there, and God, we miss you, and you passed too soon, but you left such an incredible legacy. We feel like you're here every minute.